Hello everyone, and thank you so much for being here. This is going to be my thank you so much for being here at my last presentation I'll be giving as a student at Dojo Liberty Medical High School. Now, it wasn't easy getting here, but it was worth it. Yuma saw things. Shigufa, her talking, that's her thing. But it wasn't back when I was a freshman, and I was super nervous to always publicly speak. Now, welcome to listen to not only the end of my high school journey, but how the end of this chapter is making me into the person who I am. My name is Shigufa Khan, and welcome to my senior defense. I want to begin by talking about my family, the most important people. My mom and dad, right over here. My dad's from Pakistan, my mom's from Afghanistan. And they always wanted their kids to always have a great education because they didn't have the opportunity to do that. They always wanted their kids to be successful. My oldest brother, Cotter, he just recently graduated from UC Berkeley, and he's the person I go to whenever I need advice. My two younger siblings, Rahil and Shabnam, are the one who always make me laugh whenever I'm at the lowest. Someone who I want to really talk about is Zohid. He recently passed away last year in June, and he is the strongest person whom I've ever met. He was disabled. He had a trachea, a G-tube. He couldn't walk, he couldn't move, or he couldn't talk. However, he always had a smile on his face whenever he would see his family. And even though all his hardships, he would look at us and he would know that we are his family. And the thing is, he is someone who I will always look up to, and I always feel his presence every single day. Now on to my second family. My friends here at Dojo Liberty Medical High School are one of the closest people whom I've ever met. They're the ones who've made me into the person who I am today. If without them, my high school experience wouldn't be the same. I would talk about them all individually, but that would take forever because all of them are each uniquely in their own way. Now on to my family at my workplace. I work at JCPenney's and I'm a sales associate. It's really fun to have this job, but before I got this job, I was extremely nervous because I wasn't ready to jump into the real world of having a job. However, I was beyond ready. I am a sales associate where I do a lot of recovering, cashiering, working with all the managers, and someone who I'm really close with is my general manager, Jay Caro. He is one of my mentors, and he's always helped me he always motivated to do my best in my workplace. And honestly, without these people, my job wouldn't be fun at all. So I have an amazing time working at JCPenney's, and yeah. Now I'd like to start a quote by Maya Angelou. When you do nothing, you feel overwhelmed and powerless, but when you get involved, you feel the sense of hope and accomplishment that comes from knowing you are working to make things better. With that being said, I have always loved making positive changes, and the way you get positive changes is to become involved with the school or wherever you are. That is why I became to be involved with PBIS, School Site Council, Leadership, and PTSA, as well as I volunteer at the Antioch Library, as well as Kaiser Permanente, and I've gotten involved, and I try to be present at every event that Dojo Liberty holds. The reason why I do all this involvement is because it creates a feeling inside me that I've accomplished something. Then no one else knows that feeling but yourself. When you are involved, you create those positive changes around you. And from being involved, I got to represent Dojo Liberty Medical High School at multiple events. And from doing this, I got to share my experiences that I had in Dojo Liberty Medical High School. There's a girl who's a sophomore right now, but she was a freshman. And she came up to me and she told me that I was the reason why she came to Dojo Liberty Medical High School. And she tells me she would have never came here if it wasn't for her to meet me at one of the pathway nights when she was in eighth grade. She told me she was getting involved and she cannot wait to continue her career in this high school. And I told her that she'll be the next one to represent Dojo Liberty at events. And she smiled. And that in itself is the reason why I love to be involved. And it makes me happy that I created a positive change in someone else as well. Now to my thesis. Coming to Dojo Liberty, I did not know who I was meant to be. I was always the one behind the scenes not knowing what to do or not taking on challenges that would help me succeed. As I started my 4 years at Dojo Liberty, I started to break out of my shell and learn how to be a productive citizen by utilizing all the knowledge I've gained from the rigorous courses I've taken and applying it to the real world. The many projects I have done within my high school career helped me improve my communication skills, technology skills, as well as time management skills, since there were always multiple projects given at a time. I've been shaped into the leader I am today from accepting all the opportunities that came my way from the encouragement of my peers and educators. I have surpassed my expectations and went above and beyond for everything that I did here at Dojo Liberty Medical High School, which turned me into the young, proud adult I am today. And I would like to start with a quote that by Zig Ziglar, in many ways, effective communication begins with mutual respect, communication that inspires, encourages others to do their best. Now, with saying that, communication was involved in all of our projects, and we do that every single day. In sophomore year, in my advanced English class, I did a debate. And when I found out I had to do this debate in front of a whole entire class, I was nervous because at that time, I was not ready to publicly speak about certain issues. This debate was like any other debate. You had a topic and two sides. The topic I chose to debate for was alcohol advertising, and the side that I was arguing about was that alcohol advertisement increases underage drinking. I remember preparing for this project like it was yesterday. I spent multiple hours memorizing my script that was 10 pages long, and it took me a while, and when I was memorizing my script, I was still super nervous. I will then resort to talk to my family or present my information to my family. And even when I was presenting to them, I was still nervous and I kept messing up. On the day of my debate, I went up and I spoke what I had to say. And the thing is, at the end of my debate, the class got to choose which side won, and my side won at the end. One critique I got from one of my teacher, or the my advanced English teacher, she said that I spoke very fast. And something that I learned about on that debate is when I become very passionate in a topic, I have a lot that I want to say, and I tend to speak very, very fast, which I'm still working on today. The debate I did in sophomore year definitely helped me for my narrative essay that I did in my AP or language composition in junior year. This narrative essay was a component to the Night at the Medical Museum project. And Night at the Medical Museum project is where I was in a group, and in that group we had to choose an era, which in my era was turn of the century, and in that era we had to choose a disease that was relevant. And the disease I had was rabies. The one huge component to the Medical Museum for English was the narrative essay. In this narrative essay, we had to write a fictional story about a fictional character who contracted the disease and how the treatment plan was. And so, at first, I thought this was going to be easy because this was a creative writing, and I thought I was a creative person. However, I was wrong because I was staring at a blank page for nearly 3 hours. What had happened was, is I resorted to communicating with my friends on how they were starting theirs. They told me that they were going to make their paper resemble themselves. So that's what I did. I made my person in my story resemble me. He was a young man who tried getting a job to support his parents, and while he was on the way to his interview, he got bit by rabid animals. Thankfully, Louis Pasteur, a scientist named Louis Pasteur, created a vaccine in 1880, which made the survival rate to 90%. So at the end, my character ended up surviving. The narrative essay definitely helped me build my language sophisticatedly while writing creatively, as well as helped me improve my communication skills when in need of help. In senior year, communication is definitely key, and it was definitely vital for IES, which is short for the International Economic Summit. IES was a project where you were basically a member, or you were in a group, and each of your group and yourself were basically an economic advisor to your country, and you had to know basic knowledge. The basic knowledge you had to know were like the political leaders, the population, the number one cause of death, and stuff like the landscape. And after learning about all these different things, we learned an economy, the GDP, which is used, and the GDP is basically how to find the economy of that country. And my country was Afghanistan. And the way we found the GDP is by using a mathematical equation, by using the gross domestic product that was made within the borders divided by the population, which you would get the monetary value of a person who lives in the country. Afghanistan's GDP was very, very low, and I found out that it was ranked 184 out of 195, and it was the poorest country in the entire world. From learning this, we went on to creating our Persia essay, the political, which stands for political, economical, religious, intellectual, social, as well as area/geographical. From writing this, we created a coherent essay by using Google Docs, where each member in our group got to pick a topic, and we wrote it by using Google Docs, where we all got to see what we were going to write. From doing all these components, this was all getting us prepared for our summit day. And in our summit day, we got to communicate with teachers, students, and community members about our well-being of the country. It was really cool because I learned a lot about my country, and so I got to share all the information with my peers. So something that we had to talk about that was a major topic was our health equity issue. And in Afghanistan's health equity issue was war/terrorism. So we got to, one member of our group got to debate on how it made a global impact. And we got to also wear traditional clothes, which Afghanistan won the best traditional clothes. From doing this International Economic Summit, the more we communicated, the better the outcome was. Well, what I found out from doing this project in particular is that I found that there are so many corrupt political leaders in our world today, where we need to have more people who are genuine and working for the people, not against the people. So that is why I've been looking into politics and government workers to maybe pursue a job in government. Any sufficient advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Arthur C. Clarke. Technology is becoming more advanced in the world today, and is something that employers love to see their employees have. Doja Libby, I don't remember a project where Doja Libby did not, a project where in Doja Libby where technology wasn't used. In my Algebra 2 class in junior year, I did a statistical analysis. And this statistical analysis was a component of the Night at the Medical Museum project that I explained earlier. The statistical analysis was basically where I had to find a statistic that meant or that what meant the most to me. And the one that I found out that was included rabies was the death toll of the state in Louisiana. And there was about less than 40 deaths per a range of 10 years. And that was, of course, because of Louis Pasteur, who created vaccine in 1880, where there was a chance the survival rate of surviving was 90%. And I utilized technology, and this was hours from looking into different sources, looking at videos, and et cetera. So technology was basically used in this statistical analysis. A project that I will never forget is Project EDI that I did in physics this year. And EDI stands for Envision, Discover, Design, Invent, and Execute. In Project EDI, we not only had to adapt to technology, but we also had the opportunity to create a product to help someone with a disability. For a component of the Project EDI, we had to interview someone who had a disability. And something that we had to keep in mind were the ADA laws, which were we learned in economy or in government, where it was basically that it's a civil rights law where it prohibits discrimination against anyone who has a disability. So one of my members in my group had someone who had Parkinson's disease, and this was her grandmother. And Parkinson's disease is a disorder in the central nervous system where it affects movement, including tremors. So after figuring that out, after interviewing her and remembering that law, we found out she told us that she had trouble sitting up while and sitting down. She had to get her husband to pick her up, and after that, she would use a walker. That walker in itself sparked a moment in our eyes. We thought of creating something attached to the walker. So the creation process was, we got two metals, a handlebar, and some cushion to be attached to the walker. And that was really cool because we got to use Newton's first law, which is basically when action is forced upon something that is not moving, motion will occur. At the end of this project, we also got to make a Prezi where we presented our findings or what we created, and we got above in 9.5. After this project was done, we gifted our product, which was called the Parkinstan. We gifted it to the grandmother, and she still uses it till this day, which was very impactful. Another impactful thing I did this year as a senior was the Kaiser Permanente internship, and it was one of the most best experiences I've had. The application process was very thorough, and the reason why this application process was thorough is because you would be interning for a hospital, and what is important in hospitals is HIPAA, and HIPAA is basically the importance of the confidentiality of the patients and the people in a hospital. So after reading that, the application, the rules and everything, I turned it in, and I had an interview. And this interview was very nerve-wracking because it had Donna McGee, the site director, it had Kathy, who was a manager of multiple departments, a high school counselor, and Mr. Bergerhaus, whom I wasn't really scared of. But at the end of the interview, I definitely attained interview skills that I will take on with me to my future interviews. At the end, I did get the internship, and I was placed in the emergency department with someone named Tamika Knott, and she not only taught me about the medical field, she taught me about how it is to be an administrator, the emergency department, and as well as advice about on life. 98% of the things I did in this internship, I used technology. I did DHMOs and classic pays, which are basically where registration clerks, whom is under Tamika Knott, would collect money from patients. And I would use the Excel program where I'd insert how the percentages of how much money the registration clerks collected. Since I already knew so much about the Excel program, I didn't need an introduction. However, Tamika Knott did show me some newer components to the Excel program, which brightened my advancement in technology. I also used kp.org where I did job listing process, or I posted jobs. And the funny thing is that we used a lot of codes, and I never knew that there was so much codings were impacted on the job listing process. All in all, Doja Libby has definitely helped me keep updated with the new technology that is created, as well as programs that I will take on with me throughout my life. And if I do pursue a job in politics, I'll definitely have to create videos, I'll have to create a campaign, and et cetera. So Dojo will be definitely helping me keep the knowledge going for whenever it came to technology. Leaders are made, they are not born. They are made by hard effort, which is the price which all of us must pay to achieve any goal that is worthwhile. Vince Lombardi. We have leaders all around us in Dojo Living Medical High School. And in freshman year, there was a program where upperclassmen would go to underclassmen classes to talk about the negative impacts on tobacco products. I was very inspired and motivated to become a tobacco trainer. However, I wasn't confident myself in freshman year to become a tobacco trainer. Junior year was a year when I really took a step up my game and I became a tobacco trainer, and I was a tobacco trainer for 2 years. In those 2 years, I was asked to be a leader in a group. However, I was not confident in myself to become a leader in that group. But that did not stop me from teaching an underclassman about the negative impacts on tobacco products. And this experience definitely helped me led me to take on more leadership roles in my school. Be the Change was one of my favorite projects, and Be the Change was a project where we would, in senior year, where we would basically pick an important issue and be an advocate to it. Be the Change was a project where the reason why it was we did it at the end of the year is because we learned about so many things throughout the negative events that happened within in our lifetime, like the Holocaust, slavery, medical experiments, and etc. And the reason why it was at this Be the Change project was at the end is because we learned about all these distressing events. So all the students became motivated, inspired to not only never forget about those events, but also to make a change for one of the events that we chose. And for my group and I, we chose the topic of malnutrition. They asked me to be a leader, and I took it upon them, and I was like, yes, I will lead you guys. But the thing is, I had the title of being a leader, but I did not want to be the leader. I wanted all of us to be a leader. And so what I did is I made sure that each and every one of us had a day where we could just lead the group. Because, you know, you don't want to tell people what to do. You want to collaborate with each other and work hard together to make sure everything is successful. So we did stuff like we did a presentation in underclassmen classes. We did we made posters, we gave out stickers, and at the end we did a pechakucha, which is a slide that is basically timed for 15 seconds where we talk within the time limit. And Be the Change was a project where we are not only advocates in our school but our community. So in junior year, I really wanted to learn about more of the political side of education. And so what I did is I asked Mr. Burgerhouse about any opportunities that were available, and he told me something about LCAP. At first I didn't know what LCAP was, but I went to one of the meetings and I loved it. But the thing is, they were all adults, which I felt like I wasn't welcome there. But that thought changed right away when there was adults coming to me and telling me that they're thanking me for being there because I was one of the first students on this local LCAP. And LCAP stands for Local Control Accountability Plan. There are six goals. There's goal one, school materials, goal two, school culture, goal three, social emotional support, goal four, which is English, goal five, math, and goal six, college and career readiness. And I was asked to be a facilitator, and I said, yes, I would love to take on that responsibility and really lead parents and adults, because that was something I never got to do. And in these, I got to create meetings. I got to facilitate the conversations happening in those meetings. I got to create recommendations. I got to create PowerPoints. The number one thing that I was really sad about was that there were no students involved in this plan. So with the help of Genesis and Ellie, we created a student advisory committee that has almost 20 to 25 active student advocates, where we talk about not only things that are happening in education, but things that are happening in the city as well. We had the chance to talk to board members. We also went to a city council meeting. And this has been ultimately the best experience I've ever had in my high school career. And honestly, this thing has definitely helped me learn that when you work together and collaborate, you will definitely create positive changes. And this is something I definitely see myself doing in the future, where I collaborate with people and work to solve abstract problems. So, what colleges I got into? I got into all the colleges that I applied to. However, I always knew I was going to attend Los Medanos College in the fall, because first for community purposes to still stay involved, as well as family to and money issues, as well as just because I don't know what I want to major in yet, and I want to work on finding what I really want to what I want to major in, either if it's international relations, communication, psychology. I don't know yet, but I just know that I want to pursue a career in government. My revised thesis. In the beginning, I knew Dr. Libby Medical High School was going to be challenging, but that in itself was the reason why I wanted to attend Dr. Libby, because I knew it was going to be challenging, and I wanted to see how I would deal with those challenges. I've surpassed the rigorous course selection that I took, and I grew into the proud young adult I am today. I've attained skills that I'll be taking on with me throughout my life. I took advantage of all the opportunities that Dr. Libby gave me, and I ran with it, since I learned that in every opportunity came positive results. I went from not knowing who I was to finding out my passion, which is creating positive changes around me, and that was from stepping out of my comfort zone, taking initiatives throughout my school and community to help out in any way I can. In the 4 years from attending Dr. Libby Medical High School, I turned into a leader that now knows how to effectively communicate with people I encounter, to adapt to new technologies, to identify and solve abstract problems, and to advocate and create change for important issues. Being the person who I am today, I love talking a lot, and now I know how to use my voice to create change and be the change I want to see in the world. My personal achievements. If there's such thing as the high school dream, I believed I lived it. I had so many positive opportunities that came my way, and I took it because I knew that I would learn from it, and I grew into the person who I am today because of Dr. Libby. I feel like I wouldn't have never been this successful if I went to Deer Valley or Antioch High. But Dr. Libby has always put the students, the teachers, they all pushed me to my greatest limits. And I was named the Youth Citizen of the Year this year. I've gotten scholarships, I've gotten awards, and I went to the state of California in educational meeting with educational leaders, where we talked about educational reforms, about safety and community, and it was an honor to be there. And without further ado, I am so thankful I've attended Dr. Libby, and Dr. Libby was just the best decision I've ever made in my life. And now I leave it to my panels if you guys have any questions. Thank you.
Maybe you didn't mention it. Can you take us back to Be the Change? I did not realize what your project was about.
Oh, okay. So Be the Change was a project where we got to advocate for an important issue, advocate for a certain issue. My issue was malnutrition. What we did is we went out to the community and we volunteered at local food shelters. We went to underclass. So there was actions between being an advocate. An advocate is going out into the community and basically making sure that everyone knows about that, about your issue. And what we did is we tried to prevent it by, you know, giving out fruits and vegetables to have people adopt you know, healthy eating habits.
And how did you measure if the type of work you were doing for this project was working in the community?
First of all, people, when we were volunteering, people would come up and commend us for doing such a great job by giving out the foods. And also, we had an opportunity to talk to someone who was a part of the local food bank, where she told us that she has food trucks in elementary schools that gives out fruits and vegetables. And when we presented our information to, you know, underclassmen, we presented about how you could get free fruits and vegetables, and the students actually took it upon them to, you know, go there and see for themselves.
I was going to ask you my question kind of more towards the end, Shagufa, but good job. I want to ask you, looking back at your whole Dr. Libby career, what's something that you would have told yourself early on to help shape your Dr. Libby experience? What's the thing that you would have done different or advice you would have given yourself?
What I would give myself when I was a freshman is just to go out there, put yourself out there, take opportunities, volunteer, do things that you love. And I found out my love by junior year by taking initiative by going to Mr. Berghaus and asking him, what can I do to be more involved? And that's what you have to do. You have to step out of your comfort zone, ask for help, and tell them that, how can I be more involved? And the reason is I love talking talking, and that was the number one thing I knew in the beginning. But the thing is, I didn't know how to create change or positive changes in my community or my school. The thing is, I went to someone to ask them, how can I help in my school or community? And then he led me to finding the best thing I've ever been in, which is LCAP.
Shugufa, I have a question.
Yes.
You did kind of just touch up on it, though. Can you tell me which... which event really inspired you and kind of just like turned on that switch on how you want to go into your career and what really kind of shaped what you want to, I don't know if my question is clear.
No, I could tell what you're trying to say.
Okay.
I think it, honestly, it was LCAP. LCAP was where we looked at budgeting and we looked at the different, how much money is spent on different school activities, school programs. And when I found out there was not that much money left for providing full-time bilingual aides, or we only, because in education, in our school district, we only provide part-time bilingual aides. And when I found that out, I was like, our city is so diverse, so we need full-time bilingual aides. And then when we looked at vice principals and how they're part-time and how there weren't that many money funded for student-led clubs, and we just basically began to advocate and just share my student perspective on those certain aspects and to try to give recommendations that will help, you know, create an education a funner or more reliable place for students to really just be out there and shine.
One simple question. You talked a little bit about time management. I know you're involved with so many things.
Yeah.
What was your technique of using time management, and how did you grow with that, or was it always something that you've had with
you? So for me, I love keeping myself busy. I don't like just sitting in my room doing nothing or whatever. I like to be out there. I like to have some action, you know, not just doing nothing. I always try to have a planner where I would write in all the meetings that I had. And then I had and technology was a big help with that, because I kept like reminders on my phone, like, okay, tomorrow you have a meeting, make sure you don't schedule anything like that. And junior year was the year where I really found how to really keep time manage myself, because again, we had so many projects given at a time, and I had a job, so it was kind of like crazy in a moment, but the thing is, I still found a way how to put everything together and put everything in my schedule to make sure that it doesn't collide with each other.
When you talked about it, did you notice that all classes that you were taking were involved in that project?
Yes, like Be the Change, Eddie, they're all integrated projects.
Can you explain more how they are?
So Eddie, for Night at the Medical Museum, the classes that were integrated were English, my Algebra 2 class, Spanish, as well as my physiology class. And what we had to do for physiology is for my disease, rabies, where we had to basically learn more information about the disease, and we would present our information of our disease to the whole entire class. And for English, there was a writing component, again, the narrative essay. And for Spanish, we did a health book where we talk about, you know, the health issues happening in our country. All right, thank you.